Hey everyone, welcome back to the channel. This is Ken, and today we've got some major Tesla news that you don't want to miss. From Elon Musk dropping fresh details on the Optimus robot, to Tesla's big rebound in China, to changes in the way Tesla is branding FSD, and even a bold shareholder proposal about political neutrality, this episode is packed. Stick around until the end, because every single one of these stories has huge implications for Tesla's future, its investors, and for you as a fan. Segment 1. Optimus V3, the unseen Tesla robot. Elon Musk has once again stirred up the conversation around Tesla's humanoid robot, Optimus. In a recent post on X, Musk confirmed something surprising. Tesla hasn't actually shown Optimus V3 yet. What we've been seeing in recent clips, the robots walking, handling tasks, those were still V2 or maybe V2.5. The real V3 still under wraps. Why does that matter? Because Musk himself called V3 amazing. That means we're not just looking at incremental updates anymore. This could be a leap forward, a robot that represents a core pillar in Tesla's long-term strategy. Remember, Optimus isn't just a side project. Tesla has tied its future growth, even Musk's 2025 compensation plan, partly to the success and rollout of Optimus. That tells you how seriously the company is betting on it. For investors, the question isn't just when V3 will be revealed, it's how advanced it will be, and what role it could play in Tesla's overall valuation. Segment 2. Tesla sales bounce back in China. Next up, let's talk about China, the most competitive EV market in the world. In August 2025, Tesla sold 57,152 vehicles at retail in China. That's down about 10% year over year. But here's the kicker. Compared to July, sales surged 41%, and compared to May, they jumped nearly 50%. That's a strong rebound. Wholesale deliveries from Giga Shanghai hit 83,192 units in August, the highest monthly total so far in 2025. While that's still slightly below last year's level, it's a big 22% increase from July. Clearly, momentum is back, breaking it down. Model 3 sales were 24,304 units, while Model Y hit 58,888 units, with over 26,000 of those being exports. In fact, the Model Y became the second best-selling vehicle in all of China for the month. That's massive. In terms of market share, Tesla claimed 2.9% of China's new energy vehicle market overall and 8.3% of the battery EV segment. That ranks Tesla as the 9th best-selling brand in China in August. And don't forget the newly launched 6-seater Model YL, which could further boost sales going forward. For investors, this recovery signals resilience. Tesla may face fierce competition in China, but it's proving it still has staying power in the world's largest EV market. Segment 3. FSD rebranding. From full autonomy to driver assistance. Now, this is a big one. Tesla has officially changed the way it talks about FSD, or full self-driving. For years, Tesla promoted FSD as a pathway to full autonomy, cars that could truly drive themselves with no human input. But recently, Tesla quietly shifted its definition. Now, FSD is branded as an advanced driver assistance system. That's a major shift. It makes clear that the current version of FSD still requires driver supervision. It's not full autonomy. This change also ties into Elon Musk's updated compensation plan, where the language around FSD targets was softened. Essentially, even today's FSD might count as meeting the goal. For investors and Tesla owners, this raises tough questions. Has Tesla stepped back from its bold autonomy promise? Or is this just a legal clarification while the tech continues to improve? Either way, the rebrand impacts Tesla's image, its technology narrative, and the expectations Wall Street has built over years. We'll need to watch closely how this evolves, because the gap between Tesla's vision and its current reality could influence both consumer trust and investor confidence. Segment 4, Shareholder Push for Political Neutrality. Our final story is about a bold move from a longtime Tesla investor. Jay Butera, based in Pennsylvania, has filed a shareholder proposal calling for Tesla to adopt a political neutrality policy. What does that mean? It would prohibit Tesla's executives and directors from endorsing, donating to, or publicly supporting political parties or candidates. In other words, Tesla would commit to staying apolitical. Butera isn't just any shareholder. He's held Tesla stock since its IPO in 2010 and helped found the bipartisan Climate Solutions Caucus back in 2016. His view is simple. Tesla's mission of accelerating sustainable energy shouldn't be bogged down by political fights. He even calls Elon Musk a technical genius whose passion built Tesla, but worries that Musk's political commentary risks harming Tesla's image and shareholder value. This is the first time such a concern has been formally presented to Tesla's board, and it's happening at a time when Tesla faces sales challenges and shifting market dynamics. How Tesla responds could set a precedent for the company's relationship between leadership, politics, and investors. So, four big stories today. One, Elon Musk says Optimus V3 hasn't even been revealed yet. Two, Tesla's sales in China bounced back big in August. Three, FSD is no longer marketed as full autonomy, but as driver assistance. Four, and a shareholder proposal is pushing Tesla to commit to political neutrality. Each of these highlights a different part of Tesla's identity: robotics, global sales, technology branding, and governance. Together, they show just how complex and multidimensional Tesla has become. It's not just a car company, it's a robotics company, an AI company, and an energy company, all rolled into one. Now I want to hear from you. Out of these four stories, which do you think is the most important for Tesla's future? Drop your thoughts in the comments below, because I'll be reading and responding. And before we wrap up, let's take a quick look at Tesla's stock price. Today, it's trading at $346, down slightly from the previous session. All right, that's it for today's Tesla update. If you found this video helpful, make sure to hit that like button. It really helps the channel. And if you haven't subscribed yet, join us. I post Tesla news and analysis every single day, so subscribing means you won't miss a thing. Thanks again for watching. And until next time, let's keep enjoying life with Tesla in it. Before we wrap up, let me take a moment to introduce myself. I drive a Tesla Model Y, and at home, I've installed a Tesla Powerwall, so I actually charge my car with solar energy. I truly believe Tesla is shaping the future, and that's why I share the latest news and insights here on this channel. I'm from Japan, but I want to connect with Tesla fans all around the world. That's why I also create an English version of my videos. YouTube now lets you switch the audio into your own language, so you can enjoy it in whatever language you prefer. Most of all, I'd love to connect with Tesla fans everywhere so we can support Tesla together. I also share updates on X, so feel free to follow me there and let's connect. And if you haven't already, please subscribe to this channel. I'd really appreciate it. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.